wayside, by the wayside, by the wayside. Too far gone and about the phone, and I'm all alone, and I'm all for lonely by the wayside, by the wayside.
It's chilly. Yeah, I'd throw it like the shoreline. Is kind of very, very slow. Oh, did you really? Nice. There you go. You don't think so? Look at that. That is sweet.
Boom. That was quick.
I actually wouldn't know yet. Oh, he's just too small. Hey, you want to take a pic?
Yeah.
Throw him back?
Yeah.
Good job, babe.
Is that on record?
Yep. Okay. Nice red there.
Okay, well, they're biting on
me. Yeah. Maybe we will get some big ones mixed in there, hopefully.
How short was he?
Only by a couple inches, actually. Okay. Well,
we know at least redfish. We haven't caught a redfish for a long time.
Yep. That's good to know that they're at least here. Nice, nice. I think that's a keeper.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, he's gonna be close. He's a chunky little dude though.
I think he's a keeper.
I think he is too. Alright, let's see.
He looks a little chunky.
Right now he's like, come on, stop. Alright. That's a keeper.
Yay!
Yeah, it's a keeper for sure. It's like right there, but it's, yeah, keeper? He's a keeper.
Woo-hoo!
Good job, boss. Killing the game. I think I'm going to now.
From Robert's Fresh Market.
You want a pick?
I don't really feel like touching him.
No, okay.
I'm having you for dinner tonight.
Open her up. Shrimps, where it is at.
It feels so good that I caught a shrimp, a fish.
Good job. I'm proud of my boo boo.
We've had a redfish drought for a little bit.
I know. Hopefully today's the day.
I think you need to hop on this.
I think so too.
And I caught it on.
And your good
passion.
One. All right. All right. Yeah, I'm making that switch too. Oh, come on now. Who suggested the shrimp?
Can I go? Or?
Yeah. You got it. Holy crap.
That's a good one.
Nope. Wow. No, it didn't even steal my shrimp either. Yeah. Oh, he's all dinged up.
Oh, should we put him back? We should.
Yeah.
What happened?
I don't know.
We should put him back. We have so much back.
I know. Yeah. All right, bud.
Can I see?
Yep. Yeah, I don't know what happened. See that?
Nothing.
All right, now we're both on the board.
Nice.
Yep. They are here. Damn, this the shrimp. Tell you what.
No, I
have a
hook on.
Yeah. Well.
You can still use that one, yes.
Oh yeah. I'm just gonna kind of retie them. We both need to put some fresh shrimpies on. I think we both need to put some fresh shrimpies on. No, I think we both need to.
Yeah, whenever you're ready. Don't
worry. Never mind.
Ooh, baby. Yeah, buddy.
Yeah. All right, bud. I'll keep him.
Huh?
We'll keep him. Oh, he is.
Left.
He is a left. Shut up. Stop. Jeez, angry.
Some good fish tacos.
All right, new shrimp for you. He is not happy. Actually, this guy's not bad.
Okay, then I'll keep using him.
Yeah, I'm just gonna put him up a little bit more.
Like, not do it on your
eyes. Oh shit.
Yeah, just get rid of it.
You is flexible.
So you think that was a good bass?
Yeah. Good enough to keep. I just don't want to fillet one fish. I'm going to fillet some fish.
Yeah. Well, now we got two. I'm glad we can do redfish tonight.
Yep, same.
But you want to do redfish on the half shell or just...
It doesn't matter to me.
I'm thinking what would be good for our viewers.
Yeah. Be okay.
Sorry, where should I go?
Over here.
It's a big one too.
It's a good one. Yep. Mother
bananas.
Yeah, I didn't get a good hook set on him. Son of
bananas.
That sucks. Promising, I guess. Yeah, he did. It is chilly. Yeah, you do. Look at you. Nice. Good job, babe.
I didn't even know I was a
throw that sucker in.
Do you want to throw him back? He's really little.
No, he's not. Throw him in.
Hi, little guy. I didn't even feel him at him.
No. Yeah, sometimes they just jump on like that.
You think he's okay?
Yeah.
Fun.
All right, guys. So, got another catch and cook coming to you. Had a pretty good day on the water. I'd say it was average. Caught one keeper redfish. I think you caught a throwback redfish as well. I got skunked on the reds. Did catch a couple bass as well. So the main dish tonight, though, is going to be some pan-seared or blackened redfish. It's a dish you see a lot down here in Louisiana. It's a pretty simple process. It's just some redfish seasoning, get a pan full of butter and some olive oil, and kind of sear her up, and there you go, some good old redfish. So I think we did bass last time. Oh, also too, by the way, got a blue crab, which was kind of a surprise catch. So got a pot of water boiling, gonna give that a shot as well. So let me go ahead and let's fillet this redfish, because we did not do that on the last video. We did all bass on the last one, so this is came in right about 16 inches, or actually right at 16 inches. So he's a nice keeper red. You know, this is the kind of size you want to keep, you know. All right, so pretty similar process here again with the redfish. It's going to be, again, very similar to the bass. The only thing different about the redfish I tend to find is that the rib cage the bones are a little bit, I guess a little bigger, a little stronger, so you're gonna have it's gonna be a little harder to get through those bones. But also too, redfish, they have some nice little teeth, so I kind of like to come in here by the gills to get a good grab on them, and again kind of come in again here at an angle right behind the fin, go down until you feel that backbone, angle your knife back, and then just come in here, press down as you're going. Again, try to get as much of that meat along the backbone as possible, and then again go all the way just until you get to the end of the tail. Flip it over, so pretty good there. Flip it over, get into that tail meat there, and push down. Oh, so actually this is kind of good. So this popped off. Here's a little trick for you. Grab a fork, pop that at the end of the tail here. Gotta separate that meat a little bit. Push down really, really hard. Kind of gives you a nice firm grip. That way you're not trying to use your hands and it's going to slip and slide everywhere. Boom. Press hard, press hard. Nice redfish fillet right there, I'll tell you what. Cut that rib meat out. Boom. that's going to be mighty tasty, if you ask me. Yeah, let's get some ice too for that guy. Yeah, just to get her nice and cool. Alright, toss that away, flip her over, do the other side. Hopefully I won't go through the tail meat this time. Alright. Lay there, and I'll tell you what, I don't think we could have gotten much more meat off this guy. So again, I think I talked last time about this electric fillet knife. That thing is awesome. You get so much meat off the fish when you use this. Can't go wrong with Old Bay. I mean, Old Bay's kind of the do-all of the seafood world. So I think I'm gonna do that with some garlic salt and a little bit of lemon pepper. I like to be pretty liberal with the Old Bay. Just kinda get that going on there. Now, do just a tad bit of garlic salt, not too much, because it's already got salt, or the Old Bay's already got salt in it. And then also the lemon pepper, go kind of light on that, I think. That looks good there. Flip these guys over, do the other side. Again, pretty liberal with the Old Bay. Pepper. And just a tad bit of garlic salt. All right, cool. So these guys are ready for the pan, and we'll do that here in a second. I'll show you a little trick too, how to get these guys perfectly cooked on both sides. So hold on 1 second, and we'll be back. Alright, so we got some couscous going over here too. So what I like to do is, I normally actually used to just do 2 tablespoons of butter per redfish, or I'm sorry, 2 tablespoons of butter, yeah, per redfish, so 4 total. Instead, what I've gone to is now I just do 1 tablespoon of butter per fillet, so I got 2 fillets, 2 tablespoons, and then actually add some olive oil. Alright, so we got this butter and olive oil all mixed together, all melted and everything. So here's my trick, and again, I can't take credit for this, but it works well. We put these redfish in here. Whenever you're putting them in there, if you normally were to lay them down flat, the tail in here, which is a lot thinner, will tend to cook a lot quicker. But if you flip that over, it'll end up cooking a lot more evenly, and you won't get a burnt tail. So I do like that little tip. Boom. And we'll throw these on here. Usually ends up being about, you know, 3 minutes per side-ish. Could be a little bit longer or shorter, depending on the size of the fish. 145. So I like our handy dandy little thermometer here. Stick it in there, make sure we're right at 145, and they'll be good to pull off. So I'm gonna get these all seared up and we'll be eating redfish here soon. Alright, so we got these guys ready to flip. Oh yeah, look at that. Oh my god, that looks so good. Bam! Bam! Get some emerald right there. Hey guys, shout out to Emerald, Louisiana, New Orleans. If you ain't doing this with your fish, you're missing out. Gotta do the lemon. Squeeze the lemon on top of there. Woo! Oh my god, it's looking so good. Get my belly. Alright. Boom. And what we'll do too, I like to hit it once with the lemon when we're cooking. And then also got a couple lemon wedges cut up on the plate. Hit it after two, could use just a little extra lemon on there, but these are looking good and I'm excited. All right, so these guys are good and done. Just check the temperature. Definitely good. Boom. There we go. Pretty good. Gonna be very tasty. All right, so here we go. Gonna hit it with a little bit more lemon, because lemon is life. Boom. You got it all over me, of course. Take a little bite here. Ooh, that is flaky. See, that's one good thing about redfish is it's super flaky, white, delicious fish. Wow. Yep. I'm by the wayside. That's pretty good. I'm by the wayside.